Vayakhel. Is one allowed to text message on Shabbat? It's an interesting question. Vayakhel opens with the importance of the Sabbath day once again. And there are many people who are addicted to messaging. And you'd be surprised how often I get this question. After all, the prohibition, and the prohibition is here also in Vayakhel, Lo tivaru esh b'chol moshvotechem b'yom ha-shabbat, you shall not kindle a fire in all of your habitations on the Sabbath day. And usually with electricity, there is some kind of a filament that becomes a glow, certainly hot. And therefore, whenever that happens with an electric current, it puts us squarely into the prohibition of not kindling a fire on Shabbat. But in texting, there's no such thing. In texting, I'm just writing a message, having a conversation, making a business deal. But what I'm producing is not necessarily eternal. It can be easily erased. And there is no filament that is aglow or even heated up. So why can I not technically text? And I believe there is a biblical reason for it. Because not only is there a negative, a prohibitive aspect to Shabbat, lo tivaru esh, thou shalt not do this or that or the other thing. Thou shalt not engage in creative physical activity. There is also a positive biblical expression for Shabbat. Shabbaton. It must be a restful day. Leman yanuach avdecha v'amatcha b'yom ha-shabbat. In Deuteronomy chapter 5, the second time the Sabbath appears in the dialogue. Sabbath was given in order that you may rest from physically creative activities. You and even your maidservant and manservant who are Gentiles, you must all rest physically. Now, what does this positive commandment entail? It means that not only is Sabbath a day in which you cannot do certain actions that are considered physically creative, it has to be a day that you're free to give over to spiritual concerns. It has to be a day that you're free to give over to humanistic concerns, to familial concerns. You see, 6 days a week we are engaged in collecting objects, things, in making things improved, building things, creating things. 6 days a week we're involved in the physical world that God made on 6 days. The Sabbath, I'm not involved so much in objects, in things. I'm involved in people and in relationships. And especially relationships to the people who are closest to me. To my spouse, to my children, to my family and my extended family. to my community, to God. On the Sabbath, we recognize the true calling of the individual, which is to be a ruach memalala, a communicating spirit, true communication between people. We're in the internet age. It's a very busy age. We run from thing to thing. And we're so quickly engaged in the kind of things we're engaged in, we don't even write messages with the complete words. We're out of time. And while we're receiving one message, we're looking to see if there's another message coming in. Shabbat is a day for people, not for things, not for messages, not for superficiality, but relationships. Recently, a very special young woman who was a professional dancer converted to Judaism. Her Jewish partner actually was a star in Wicked on Broadway. She was a very special young woman. She is. And when she came before the conversion board, the question I asked her in front of my two rabbi colleagues was, "What do you like most about Judaism?" She said, "Shabbat." And I asked further, "What do you like most about Shabbat?" She said, "No telephones." She said, "You know, before I learned about Shabbat, we never looked at each other. We could be eating together, but we didn't look at each other. Not I and my parents, not I and my boyfriend. We didn't look at each other. We were looking at that cell phone. And who was our next caller? And what was our next text message?" And you know, it's fascinating that the actual verse in the Bible reads, "Al yetzei ish mimkomo biyom haShabbat." A person should not leave his place on the Sabbath day. One day a week, stay at home with your loved ones. Don't escape the things that should be closest to you. Your spouse, your children, your extended family, your community, your God, yourself, and the God within you. That's the glory of the Sabbath. If you are plugged in 6 days a week, you desperately need one day a week to plug out. A day for true relationships. A day for loving relationships. A day dedicated to those who are closest to you and your God. Shabbat Shalom.